I'm Blake X, and this is another nuclear reaction. So do you remember back when I did those Marrow reactions? It's a band I'm still a huge fan of. The band personally sent me a signed copy of their EP, back when this channel was in its early days, and I've pretty much followed their music ever since. So Marrow Lysenko also does vocals in a death metal band called Condemned to Dream. And today I'm about to hear them for the very first time with their song I Become. And this was another request from my friend and supporter Steve Stahl. And Steve, if you don't already know, has an awesome Facebook page called Brutal Female Fronted Metal. And take my word for it, it's worth checking out. So look for the link in the description and definitely give it a like and a follow. Now, aside from the fact that Mara really brings the fire with her vocals, I don't know what else to expect from this song, or really from the band in general, but I'm feeling the right kind of energy today for some death metal. So before we dive in, I just want to let you guys know that you can do what Steve did and what others have done, which is to get VIP treatment to your song requests and guarantee a reaction to them as soon as possible. How do you do that? You do it by becoming a patron and hopping on tier 4. That's patreon.com/nuclearreactions. It'll be linked in the description beneath this video. And of course, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button to become part of the nuclear family, then hit that bell for notifications. And finally, also in the description, you'll find the links to my second YouTube channel, Nuclear Reactions Archives, the merch store, and the Facebook group, The Mushroom Cloud. All great ways to share your love and support for this channel. Again, check them out if they catch your interest. Alright, it's time for some death metal. Condemned to Dream, I Become, off their album Black Emerald Cold, which is an awesome album title, by the way. Let's check it out, guys. In 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, this is already my speed. So I love what the guitar is doing in this song so far. The riffs are awesome. It just really gets me pumped. It really gets me psyched. We're off to a great start. And of course, Mara's vocals, it should go without saying, but it's the perfect fit for this style of music. You know what it reminds me of? And I don't mean this in a bad way, but the guitar work makes me think of some melodic death metal that I heard, especially back in the early 2000s. The riffs just take me back to that time period when I was listening to a lot of Melodeath. That's the main thing that's grabbing me so far. I love Mara's vocals, but the guitar is really on point so far. So, we're off to a great start. Let's jump back in. These are the eyes I see, reflecting back, they go from me. So, like this riff right here. This reminds me of melodic death metal. It definitely has a lot of touch to it, and I'm really liking it. Okay, as I always like to say when I do these reactions, I'm no musical expert, I'm no musician. But this seems to have a touch of the Gothenburg influence to it. And it sort of reminds me of some At the Gate songs in terms of the guitar work. It's just really cool. It's very sharp, it's very caustic, but it's also... it has a melodic sensibility to it underneath all the heaviness, and that's a very nice match for this song. So I'm really sold on this so far. I'm really loving this, actually. It's just like kicking my brain around in the best possible way. It's definitely a banger. I'm really enjoying it. So let's jump back in. Take another breath, another day, ferociousness of this song is crazy good. Playlist. That's rubbing too. Holy shit. See this melody right here, I'm digging this. Is there gonna be a drop? Bring the drop. This is fucking fantastic so far. I love this. I gotta say something really, really brutally honest. This is one of the best metal songs that I've heard in months. The energy on this, the ferocity to this, the guitar work on this is so good. I'm like sweating, just headbanging and vibing out to this song, but this is like a hidden gem. And you know, Steve told me that Condemned to Dream, this album, Black Emerald Cold, kind of flew under the radar, unfortunately. It needs to be on the radar, it needs to be way above the radar, it needs to be like in everyone's ears. It needs to be on playlists. It's just really, really good. And maybe it's the energy that I'm feeling today as well. You know, I have big energy days, I have low energy days, as we all do. This is a big one for me, but this song is going along with it so well, not only for that reason, but because it's just the sheer brutality and the sheer awesomeness of the music itself is just really connecting with me today. I'm really liking this. I want to hear more from this band. Mara's vocals are great here, but again, the number one thing is the guitar, and it really has some callbacks to me, you know, to melodic death metal that I've heard, and this may sound weird, but the guitar work, especially when it gets very melodic, even has some callbacks to early 2000s metalcore for me. And we did hear that breakdown in the song as well. So there's some kind of lingering core element in here. And I don't mean that as an insult. I mean it as a compliment. Because it's really paying off dividends to the overall sound and the overall impact of the song. But I hate to even pause it to offer these thoughts because I just want to get back into it. So let's dive back in. That's drumming too. Ooh, I like that. Giving the bass a little prominence. I want to listen to this entire fucking album. Two-word fire drumming. So on point. See, right there, that sounds so... It's very melodic death metal, you know? It even reminds me a little bit of some guitar work that I've heard in Amon Amarth songs. And maybe these are weird comparisons. It's just that's where it's bringing my head to while I'm listening to it. Yeah, so I really like everything the guitar is doing. It's going to so many different places in the song. It's incredibly good. And Mara's vocals, of course, are just so well-suited to this genre. I can't wait to hear the rest of this album, and I hope they continue with this band, because this is, like, right up my alley. It is my alley. So let's finish it up. That deserves a round of applause. That was a great track. That really impressed me. It really did. You know what, Steve? Out of all the suggestions you've made to me since, like, the dawn of this channel, I'm going to say this is, at the very least, in the top five. Maybe even the top three. Probably the top three. This really blew me away. It just... It was great in all the right places, and it didn't sound like more of the same. As much as it reminded me, again, callbacks to early 2000s, little bits of metalcore, little bits of Melodeath. Those were excellent callbacks, and there were definitely comparisons drawn in my mind as I was listening to this. But it still sounded fresh. It sounded unique. They put their own spin on this song, their own stamp on this. And it just really sounded fucking incredible. Like, Mara's vocals matched with everything the guitar work was doing. It was just an explosive combination that really paid off. And, of course, you can't deny the skill that went into the drumming. The bass also made itself pronounced, especially toward the end of the song, where you had that little part with the bass line. That was really cool. I wish they had done that a little bit more, actually, in the song, because that was a nice little break between the heaviness, between the heavy parts. So that was a cool little bit of a divergence, you know, in the song. Structured very well. The impact was great. The heaviness was great. The mixing on this, to my ear, sounded great. Every instrument was given its time to shine, and nothing seemed to drown out anything else. It was all very nicely balanced and just a really heavy, but also really, you know, maybe some people will hate when I use this word, but melodic in its own kind of heavy way. It was heavy and melodic. So a combination that I think is hard to pull off that doesn't work out probably 5 or 6 times out of 10. But in this case, it definitely worked out. It definitely made the song great. They struck that balance wonderfully. And as the introduction track to Black Emerald Cold, this is one hell of a kickoff. I mean, I become. This is going on a playlist for me. This is the song of the week for me. I can tell you that right now. And I want to hear more from this album. I got to be honest. Right now, I'm resisting the urge to just, after finishing this video, to just play through the entire album from track one to the end. You know, starting with this song again and then just finishing out the entire record. But I'm not going to do that because I'm a reactor, and I do want to react to more from this band in the future. So if there's any tracks that stand out to you, Steve or anyone else who's interested, leave a request in the comments or message me. You guys know the drill. Otherwise, you have the Patreon option. But does this get me pumped for this album? Hell yes. And this, I believe, was released in 2019, and this really did fly under the radar because, aside from maybe hearing the name before, I wasn't familiar with this until Steve got in touch with me about it. So, clearly, I've been missing out. I think all of you guys have been as well. I really dug this, every last bit of it. It was just absolutely great. One of the best songs I've heard in a long time. I seriously mean that. So, that's the music. Nothing else to say. Got nothing bad to say. No criticisms. Just all around great. Now let's get into the lyrics. Eyes expose the soul, reflect the cold loss of control. These haunted eyes I see, reflect back, they confront me with desperation. Apprehension grips me, wraps me in the embrace I can't escape. I barely have the strength to lift my eyes to the glass. Searching, I look for a clue that can tell me, what have I done? Screams echo in me, but I cannot pinpoint the source. Their terror, their piercing horror. My mind seeks answers, but I am only finding pain. The searing anguish of change as I become. Shaken, I take another breath, another day with the same dread of what I have done. Metamorphos grips, corrupts me in ways I don't understand. I am horrified to see that my desires and my wants are only a lust for the pain and the terror, and this is wrong. Dark seeds from darker deeds, dreams fueled by diseased desires, pain is sacred, the darkness in the ever-rotted core. The feral rise, the primal abandon, the carnal release of the beast in me as I become. These haunting eyes I see, reflected back, they smile at me victoriously. I revel in the vicious fantasies created in my mind. It only serves to prime me for my time to rage. Eager, I strain to find the control. I can do what must be done. So just to sort of... Yeah, to sort of preface what I want to say about these lyrics, you know, there's the Jungian concept of the shadow self. It's the unconscious side of yourself that usually has the attributes that we would like to pretend we don't have. You know, usually ones that we deem immoral or unacceptable. In many cases, we see them as flaws or weak spots within ourselves. But really, that side of ourselves is part of the balance of being human. And accepting only half of yourself and basically denying the rest is not the right way to go. So a lot of people would describe the shadow self as sort of the beast inside, right? It's the more instinctual, raw emotion, carnal part of us. And I think there's always a time and place to let it out. There's always a right moment to tap into it or to embrace that part of yourself. It's just that people largely seem to get it wrong, one way or the other. Because they go to one of two at different extremes. In other words, some people lean too heavily on that part of themselves, and their unchecked instincts and emotions drive all of their behavior, with zero reasoning and zero rational thought. And then other people go the opposite way, where they just repress and repress and repress that side of themselves until they develop all kinds of self-loathing and psychological problems. And you see this all the time with people who follow a lot of right-hand path religions. So much repression of everything from anger to you know, dealing with depression, to emotional needs, to sexual needs, all of that gets repressed. So many people with Catholic upbringings suffer from that. But that's just one example. You know, people from all walks of life, you know, it doesn't matter what your background is, how you grew up, people repress that side of themselves, and that's not good either. But when these lyrics talk about a cold loss of control, metamorphosis, the carnal release of the beast in me as I become, to me, that's talking about the first category that I mentioned, where you completely lose control and you just let that inner beast loose. And you lose the ability to check your actions, or keep yourself in check is a better way to put it. And I think the verses here reflect that pretty well. Dark seeds from darker deeds, dreams fueled by diseased desires. And then later, the feral rise, the primal abandon, the carnal release of the beast in me, as I become. So, you know, this relates to my own personal philosophy. You're always going to get a personalized analysis with these reactions. So, you know, part of this is coming from what I believe. But to me, there's a way to strike that balance of channeling the darker or more primal aspects of human nature while also still being a rational and self-responsible person. And for me, it's this: indulgence, not compulsion. It's about that key difference. When you actively choose to indulge in or to fulfill your human needs and desires, you're in control, right? But when you feel compelled to give into that side of yourself over and over again, it controls you. It's the other way around. And that's the difference. And so I feel like this is someone who wanted to give in to that inner beast, that inner dark side, but now they're spiraling out of control and, you know, losing control over themselves and over their own life. The shadow self is dominated completely to the detriment of better logic and reasoning. And this line here, I think this line here reflects that nicely. These haunting eyes I see reflected back, they smile at me victoriously. It's the idea of losing your self-determination and losing those aspects of yourself that let you function normally and dictate your own actions and your own choices. And now this person has taken themselves to a place where they've lost that choice. And I think a lot of people, you know, in reality, actually have that fear. You know, the chance to determine their own path in life and to make choices for themselves. You know, of course, sometimes choices can lead us to a place where we have our choices taken away, which is actually pretty interesting in an ironic kind of way. You know, it's just one of those things, man. Like, the human condition basically being so strange and so self-contradictory, because you can choose to open yourself up in a way that feels liberating and feels great, but it can take you to a place where you burn yourself to the ground later on. So I really think the song is grappling with the simple question of, what have I become? Again, very simple title, I Become, straight to the point. It can be taken literally or metaphorically, as in, you get to a place in life where you look in the mirror and you may feel trapped within yourself. You might feel like you've changed into something where your control and your free will has been removed, just taken out of the equation. So, and, you know, look, that's why I think self-reflection is so important. In fact, let me put it this way to better describe what I'm getting at. Imagine you're reading a book or you're watching a movie, but you're skipping past certain parts of it that you don't agree with, or maybe you don't want to read or watch those parts. Maybe you don't like them as much as other parts of the book or the film. But then because you skipped those parts, you then don't have a full understanding of the story or what it's about. So then you might develop an opinion or an idea about the story that might not be fully accurate, since you're speaking partly from ignorance. Because you didn't see or read the whole thing, you're basing your thoughts and your actions solely off of the parts that you chose to absorb. So it's the same way with what you think of yourself and the actions and the choices that you make. If you're choosing not to confront or not to analyze certain parts of who you are, whether it's the shadow self or even the more rational, intellectual side, whatever the case may be, if you're choosing not to confront certain aspects of yourself, then you won't fully know yourself. And without having that grip on who you are, by choosing to be ignorant of your full identity, you could eventually lose yourself. You know, and I think this song touches upon the end of the road when that's how you choose to go through life. Of course, to be fair, it could just be a cool fucking metal song about unleashing the beast within. And if looked at that simply, I think that's perfectly great too, you know. Maybe I'm overthinking it. But again, whether intentional or not, as I often say on this channel, the great thing about music and art in general is that it leaves things open for interpretation. But on the other hand, at the same time, I'm not sure who wrote the lyrics here, if it was Mara herself or another band member, but I do know that in the band Mara, a lot of the songs dealt with confronting personal demons, like the song Life Kills, and other songs even dealt with psychology and the idea of losing yourself, like the song Label Me Insane, both of which I've reacted to, by the way, if you want to search on my channel for them and check them out. Highly recommend it. Shameless self-promotion. But yeah, so it's not too far-fetched to think that this song could be as deep lyrically as I am making it out to be. And if it is going that deep, then that's where I think it's going. And that's something that's relatable for everyone, because we all have small parts of ourselves that we push deeper down and we don't confront. You know, show me someone who says that they're 100% in tune with who they are on a perfect level, and I'll show you somebody who's in denial. So, to me, this is a song about just letting the inner beast out of the cage to the extent that you no longer have control over your actions. You know, a darkness that you wrestled with and you lost. So, a very metal song, in other words. So the lyrics are pretty on point. Straightforward, but brought me to an interesting place. And the music was just fucking fire. I loved every minute of it. It was great. Everything I said about it has already been said. I'm just heaping praise on it, but really, I'm a big fan of it. I really am. So, can't wait to hear more Condemned to Dream. As far as this one goes, you already know what's coming. 12 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. Don't even have to think about it. Loved everything about this. And if you appreciated this band, I'm going to leave all relevant links in the description below so you can show them your support. Very important to shine the spotlight on up-and-coming bands that you enjoy. And that's about it for this reaction. If you made it this far, thank you for watching. Thank you for the support. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. All it takes is one click. Hit that bell for notifications. Check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. That'll also be in the description. And thank you to Steve for the suggestion. I personally think it's one of the best ones you've recommended to me, like, since the very beginning. So can't wait to see what else you have in store. But until then, much love and respect to the Nuclear family, and I will catch you all on the next one.